So the world we know of today is generally a very toxic environment. You know, falling demand, people are not selling, banks failing, companies faltering. Now, what does this lead to? We know of corporate frauds, financial misstatements, company failures. And as investors, sometimes we lose money. Yes or no? You recognize the man in this picture? What's his name? Warren Buffett. I hope that doesn't cause you to think about dinner. World's second richest man, and he said that when the tide goes out, that's when you know if a person is swimming naked. Because if the tide is high, he's swimming naked, nobody knows. So what he really means about that in terms of financial statements is that if you do not know how to read financial statements, you could be up to here in trouble, a company, and you're nonetheless, you're none the wiser. But if you know how to look and see and read in between the lines, things can become obvious to you. So what we want to do is to go and take a dive and see what happened to the company, looking through the financial statements. So what are financial statements? Simply autobiographies of companies. They write a book, a story about themselves every year. How do you verify who verifies that's true, accurate, correct? The auditors. Three basic financial statements: balance sheet, income statement, cash flow. So let's go through them one at a time. The farm story. Now imagine you want to buy a farm. Why are we talking about farm? How many people here attended Dr. Mark Faber's talk just now? You never attend. What a waste. You should have attended. Come, never mind. Anyway, you want me to tell you a tip? What he says, yes or no? What he said was that he said you must invest in farms. That's what he said. Commodities and farms. So imagine you want to buy a farm. The farm costs $100,000. You look into the piggy bank account, you have $80,000. Question, gentlemen, ladies, can you buy the farm? Yes or no? You need 100, you only have 50. Can you buy? No, if you don't have enough money. Yes, if you can get some OPM. What's OPM? Other people's money. If you go and borrow, you get other people's money, you can get a farm. So 80-20 allows you to buy the farm. So if you ask the CPA, what the CPA will say to you? You explain the same story by way of this diagram in a box. It says A represents what's an asset. $100,000, how did you pay for it? You borrowed $20,000 and you used $80,000 of your own money, which equals equity. So a quick definition, what is A? A simply stands for assets, which is what you own. L stands for liabilities, which is what you owe. And equity stands for your own money. Clear so far? Three elements, A, E, and L. So this is what we call the law of balance. Assets equals to equity plus liability. Think about it. What we are saying here is that for every dollar of asset that a company has, it has to fund it by two sources of capital. One, you get it from your own money. Shareholders put in money. Number two, you borrow the money. Or turn it around, E equals A minus L. Clear so far? Good.